हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर सकते हैं और अपने फ्रेंड्स में इस चैनल को रेकमेंड कर सकते हैं ग्रुप्स में, और बेल आइकन प्रेस कर सकते हैं आप, ताकि आपको डेली डिक्टेशन जो भी मैं अपलोड करता हूं वो उसकी नोटिफिकेशन आपको मिल सके। आज आपको ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 53 की मैं डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड करूंगा, पहले 70 वर्ड पर मिनट पर, उसके बाद 85 वर्ड पर मिनट पर, एंड देन 105 वर्ड पर मिनट पर। सो सबसे पहले मैं आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं 70 वर्ड पर मिनट पर, बी रेडी फॉर इट। मिस्टर स्पीकर सर, यस्टरडे द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर एंड टुडे द चेयरमैन ऑफ द सिलेक्ट कमिटी हैव फुल्ली एक्सप्लेन्ड द वेरियस क्लॉजेज ऑफ द बिल एंड सर्टेन इम्पॉर्टेंट changes that have been effected by the select committee. I propose to confine myself to two or three important features of the bill which require re-examination and close attention by the government. Sir, I need hardly emphasize the important role which the electricity supply undertakings play in the national economy of the country. Indeed, the development in other spheres depends upon the full development of the supply of power, and this bill is of vital importance, affecting as it does the development of electric supply undertakings in the country. I am focusing attention on the role that the private electricity undertakings are playing in the supply of electric power, with a view to drawing the attention of government to the difficulties that are bound to be faced by these electricity undertakings in one or two directions. In this connection, I would not, therefore, like to take much of the time of the house, but I would like to draw the attention of the honorable minister to what my honorable friend Shri Tulsidas has stated, and with whose comments I am in full agreement. As a matter of fact, the approach of the government to the bill is to fulfill three basic considerations so vital for the healthy growth of this industry. Firstly, that its proper control and regulation is but necessary. I fully agree that this is subject to certain differences on basic aspects, but the important consideration governing this bill is to attempt at providing suitable incentives to the industry, which alone can enable it to increase its capacity to the desired extent. Therefore, I would like to refer to the incentives as provided in the bill and to the need for liberalizing the clause in respect of the fair return to the investors in these undertakings. I would like to draw the the attention of the Honorable Minister to the fact that since the passing of the original Act in 1948, only 8 states throughout the country have constituted the statutory electricity boards. Among these states are Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Rajasthan, Punjab, Orissa, and Maharashtra, and therefore we find that many of the states have still to constitute these electricity boards. I would like to know from the Honorable Minister why in the matter of the constitution of electricity boards many of the states have not implemented the provisions of the bill and what the central government have done to ensure that these electricity boards are constituted in all the states as desired in the provisions of the original act. Perhaps it may have been the problem of taxation which some of the states may have in view while not proceeding with the constitution of the electricity boards. But whatever might be the reason, and even as far as this question of taxation is concerned, the central government may have to lay down some sort of subvention or such other assistance as is found necessary. I think that this matter of the constitution of the electricity boards throughout all the states is of vital importance and should be looked into by the central government to ensure that necessary steps are taken in the remaining states for the constitution of these boards. I would now like to say something about the deferred taxation reserve about which the Honorable Minister yesterday said that the amendment regarding this has been brought forward at the instance of the Federation of Electricity Undertakings. The whole complication arises due to the fact that the provisions of the Income Tax Act and the provisions of the Electricity Supply Act are contradictory to each other. While the Income Tax Act with an accelerated depreciation in earlier years results in larger tax relief in the earlier period and thereby the tax liability of the undertakings is deferred for a future period, the Electricity Supply Act restricts the provision of depreciation to a much lesser degree, and to that extent, the profits of the electricity undertakings in regard to the income tax development and depreciation rates are restricted. That act lays down a smaller depreciation as compared to what is allowed under the Indian Income Tax Act. What has now been done has been put with certain restrictions that it does not really solve the demand that was put forward by the Federation. As a matter of fact, if the electricity undertakings should have been allowed to set aside that reserve for taxation liability for future years out of the profits which they earn year by year out of the rate increase which they have put into force from time to time, that would have met the needs of the situation. दोस्तों ये थी डिक्टेशन 70 वर्ड पर मिनट पर और अब मैं आपको डिक्टेशन दो रहा हूँ 85 वर्ड पर मिनट पर. सो बी रेडी फॉर इट. मिस्टर स्पीकर सर, येस्टरडे द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर एंड टुडे द चेयरमैन ऑफ द सिलेक्ट कमिटी have fully explained the various clauses of the bill and certain important changes that have been effected by the select committee. I propose to confine myself to two or three important features of the bill which require re-examination and close attention by the government. Sir, I need hardly emphasize the important role which the electricity supply undertakings play in the national economy of the country. Indeed, the development in other spheres depends upon the full development of the supply of power, and this bill is of vital importance affecting as it does the development of electric supply undertakings in the country. I am focusing attention on the role that the private electricity undertakings are playing in the supply of electric power with a view to drawing the attention of government to the difficulties that are bound to be faced by these electricity undertakings in one or two directions. In this connection, I would not therefore like to take much of the time of the House, but I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister to what my Honorable friend Shri Tulsidas has stated and with whose comments I am in full agreement. As a matter of fact, the approach of the government to the bill is to fulfill three basic considerations so vital for the healthy growth of this industry. Firstly, that its proper control and regulation is but necessary. I fully agree that this is subject to certain differences on basic aspects but the important consideration governing the bill is to attempt at providing suitable incentives to the industry which alone can enable it to increase its capacity to the desired extent. Therefore, I would like to refer to the incentives as provided in the bill and to the need for liberalizing the clause in respect of the fair return to the investors in these undertakings. I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister to the fact that since the passing of the original Act in 1948, only 8 states throughout the country have constituted the statutory electricity boards. Among these states are Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Rajasthan, Punjab, Orissa, and Maharashtra, and therefore we find that many of the states have still to constitute these electricity boards. I would like to know from the Honorable Minister why in the matter of the constitution of electricity boards, many of the states have not implemented the provisions of the bill, and what the central government have done to ensure that these electricity boards are constituted in all the states as desired in the provisions of the original act. Perhaps it may have been the problem of taxation which some of the states may have in view while not proceeding with the constitution of the electricity boards, but whatever might be the reason, and even as far as this question of taxation is concerned, the central government may have to lay down some sort of subvention or such other assistance as is found necessary. I think that this matter of the constitution of the electricity boards throughout all the states is of vital importance and should be looked into by the central government to ensure that necessary steps are taken in the remaining states for the constitution of these boards. I would now like to say something about the deferred taxation reserve about which the Honorable Minister yesterday said that the amendment regarding this has been brought forward at the instance of the Federation of Electricity Undertakings. The whole complication arises due to the fact that the provisions of the Income Tax Act and the provisions of the Electricity Supply Act are contradictory to each other. While the Income Tax Act, with an accelerated depreciation in earlier years, results in larger tax relief in the earlier period, and thereby the tax liability of the undertakings is deferred for a future period, the Electricity Supply Act restricts the provision of depreciation to a much lesser degree, and to that extent, the profits of the electricity undertakings in regard to the income tax development and depreciation rates are restricted. That act lays down a smaller depreciation as compared to what is allowed under the Indian Income Tax Act. What has now been done has been put with certain restrictions that it does not really solve the demand that was put forward by the Federation. As a matter of fact, if the electricity undertakings should have been allowed to set aside that reserve for taxation liability for future years out of the profits which they earn year by year, out of the rate increase which they have put into force from time to time, that would have met the needs of the situation. So, दोस्तों ये थी dictation 85 word per minute पर. अब मैं आपको dictation दूंगा 105 word per minute पर. So, be ready for it. Mr. Speaker, sir, yesterday the honorable minister and today the chairman of the select committee have fully explained the various clauses of the bill and certain important changes that have been effected by the select committee. I propose to confine myself to two or three important features of the bill which require re-examination and close attention by the government. Sir, I need hardly emphasize the important role which the electricity supply undertakings play in the national economy of the country. Indeed, the development in other spheres depends upon the full development of the supply of power, and this bill is of vital importance, affecting as it does the development of electric supply undertakings in the country. I am focusing attention on the role that the private electricity undertakings are playing in the supply of electric power, with a view to drawing the attention of government to the difficulties that are bound to be faced by these electricity undertakings in one or two directions. In this connection, I would not, therefore, like to take much of the time of the House, but I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister to what my Honorable friend Shri Tulsi Das has stated, and with two whose comments I am in full agreement. As a matter of fact, the approach of the government to the bill is to fulfill three basic considerations so vital for the healthy growth of this industry. Firstly, that its proper control and regulation is but necessary. I fully agree that this is subject to certain differences on basic aspects, but the important consideration governing this bill is to attempt at providing suitable incentives to the industry, which alone can enable it to increase its capacity to the desired extent. Therefore, I would like to refer to the incentives as provided in the bill and to the need for liberalizing the clause in respect of the fair return to the investors in these undertakings. I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister to the fact that since the passing of the original Act in 1948, only 8 states throughout the country have constituted the statutory electricity boards. Among these states are Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Rajasthan, Punjab, Orissa, and Maharashtra, And therefore, we find that many of the states have still to constitute these electricity boards. I would like to know from the Honorable Minister why in the matter of the constitution of electricity boards, many of the states have not implemented the provisions of the bill and what the central government have done to ensure that these electricity boards are constituted in all the states as desired in the provisions of the original act. Perhaps it may have been the problem of taxation which some of the states may have in view while not proceeding with the constitution of the electricity boards, but whatever might be the reason, and even as far as this question of taxation is concerned, the central government may have to lay down some sort of subvention or such other assistance as is found necessary. I think that this matter of the constitution of the electricity boards throughout all the states is of vital importance and should be looked into by the central government to ensure that necessary steps are taken in the remaining states for the constitution of these boards. I would now like to say something about the deferred taxation reserve about which the Honorable Minister yesterday said that the amendment regarding this has been brought forward at the instance of the Federation of Electricity Undertakings. The whole complication arises due to the fact that the provisions of the Income Tax Act and the provisions of the Electricity Supply Act are contradictory to each other. While the Income Tax Act, with an accelerated depreciation in earlier years, results in larger tax relief in the earlier period and thereby the tax liability of the undertakings is deferred for a future period, the Electricity Supply Act restricts the provision of depreciation to a much lesser degree, and to that extent, the profits of the electricity undertakings in regard to the income tax development and depreciation rates are restricted. That act lays down a smaller depreciation as compared to what is allowed under the Indian Income Tax Act. What has now been done has been put with certain restrictions that it does not really solve the demand that was put forward by the Federation. As a matter of fact, if the electricity undertakings should have been allowed to set aside that reserve for taxation liability for future years out of the profits which they earn year by year, out of the rate increase which they have put into force from time to time, that would have met the needs of the situation. So, दोस्तों ये थी डिक्टेशन 105 वर्ड पर मिनट पर. उम्मीद है आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छे से इसे लिखा होगा. इसको ट्रांसक्राइब ज़रूर करिए. डेली डिक्टेशन में एक प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ आपको. लास्ट क्लास में मैंने आपको GDBIST की डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड की थी जो कि काफ़ी हाई स्पीड पर थी. तो उम्मीद है आप लोग अच्छी मेहनत कर रहे हैं और जितने भी वर्ड्स आपको डिफ़िकल्ट लग रहे हैं उन्हें नोट डाउन ज़रूर करें और उनकी प्रैक्टिस बार बार करते रहें. अब आपसे मुलाकात करूँगा मैं अगली क्लास में. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय. टेक केयर.